Hi, Mike Hagan. Welcome to another edition of Mike Hagan and the Strength Team Podcast. And today is, oh my gosh, Will, what is today?
Today is November the 9th.
I asked you this last podcast.
Today is November the 9th. I hope today is.
We were in, last podcast we did, Will and I did together, and we were
at Washington area.
My fifth grade, where I went to school in the fifth grade, Valhalla Elementary.
That's right.
If you didn't catch that.
How could I forget? Mike went in looking for his fifth grade teacher. How about that?
Yeah. My fifth grade teacher, I just did the math on it. I think she was 94, but yeah. She wasn't there anymore. Anyway, been having a great time traveling. We did that event, of course, last week in Seattle. Mm-hmm. At that same time, we had another team, Andy, Gavin, Greg Mead, with John Erbley up in North Dakota. And they just had an unbelievable crusade. First week in Jamestown, North Dakota, and then 3 days in Harvey, North Dakota. And then I came from Seattle. We did a program at Pathways Community Church right there in Largo, Florida. Then flew to Detroit, and we're with a community center, the community church, or the community. It was like a YMCA.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't like a church, but they brought the strength team to do their awards upward. It's not an upward program, but it's like upwards.
Okay.
And it was phenomenal. Then flew back to, did a program in St. Pete where we did a school assembly. A couple shots we showed of that, and then, you know, to the Florida Keys.
You've been a very busy man.
The last couple of days, to be honest with you, I've been resting.
Yes.
And, in fact, Pastor Charles, I was here at First Baptist Church Key Largo, where we're going to be at tonight. And man, I tell you what, we came in here, sat in the front row, and the whole message was on rest. And I was like, man,
right up your
this,
alley,
this
huh?
is, I need to be here today. This is was the message for me. And it's important. You know, because we're not made to be human doings. We're made to be human beings.
Human beings, that's
correct.
Right.
So
correct.
How do you feel?
You know what? Speaking of rest, I kind of learned that the hard way last week. We're out in Washington, and we do a feat of strength where you find the biggest guy in the audience, you put him on your back, and
Clarence,
you do push-ups.
Clarence,
I got it from Big Clarence Lee. Well, Clarence Lee has a 600-pound bench press. William Green is, you know, maybe close to 400 pounds. But anyway, I put the guy on my back.
Andre Sims picked him out. I just want
Big
you to
Dre,
know.
Big Dre, thanks, Dre. You, yeah.
Yeah.
So, long story short, the next day I wake up and my back is completely gone. So it was actually good for me that I got rest last week. I got to rest up and heal up. I was in the bed for about 5 days, and I'm getting back in the swing of things. It was good to be down here in Key Largo.
Well, you better be in the swing of things tonight.
Oh, it'll be good. I'm ready to go.
Tonight we start. We have a program where Andre Sims and Herb Hartso are going to be in Seattle, Washington, at Issaquah, at a great church there, and. Tonight, of course, we'll start First Baptist Church, Key Largo,
right.
And then Thursday, a day of rest, and then Friday, we're going to Miami Gardens area. Then we're going to be doing all the crossover events, 12 block parties in the Miami area right before the state convention, Florida Southern Baptist there State Convention is going to be, and we're going to try it. I don't know how we're going to do it, but they got us going to 12. You don't know.
Well, we'll have Big Zeb Bishop. Coming down with us, that was about 6'5", 300 plus pounds. He'll be a good addition. He'll help us carry the load when he gets here this week.
We will need the help.
Yes, Zeb.
And then finish on Monday night, Miami Shores, and then off to Iowa, back to Iowa for the 14th year in a row. It's either 13th or 14th year. I think it's the 14th year that we've been 14th, back 14th, to Waterloo, right. Iowa. For the first 13 years of celebration. Great church, my good friend Pastor Don Cox. Appreciate him so much. But anyway, that's just kind of an update about what's going on. And so what I wanted to do is just have a word for our audience, because we always try to give you like updates, but we always want to encourage our crowd.
Absolutely.
With our partners. I know a lot of partners, and you might have got the Haiti mailer this week, and so. Respond, help us go to Haiti.
We need a lot of support.
We need to raise about $15,000
yes.
to get there. And
it's for a very good cause.
Believing to reach a lot of people. It's going to be for a great investment.
They need it.
So anyway, this is what I was reading this morning. Hebrews 12, very powerful. The first two verses where it says, therefore, since we are surrounded by such a great cloud of witnesses, let us throw off everything that hinders us and the sin that so easily entangles us. Man, isn't that where a lot of people are today? And let us run with perseverance and run the race that marked out for us. And now here's the key right here. Man, if we can get a hold of this right here in 2, where it says, let us fix our eyes on Jesus, the author and the perfecter of our faith,
yes,
who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, scorned its shame, and sat down at the right hand of God, the throne of God. And he makes intercession for you and I daily.
He's already done.
In the midst of the crazy world, and it seems like things just keep going faster and faster.
Especially nowadays, yeah.
And the world that we live in, you know, current news, things that are going on, the election, the economy, all the different stuff, different happening. It's really important just to slow down and put our eyes on Jesus.
That's right.
Because it's so easy to get knocked off course. And I know I want this podcast to go too long, but I know that a lot of people, where it talks about in Galatians 5 and 7, where it says you are running a good race, who cut in on you and stopped you from obeying the truth, that kind of persuasion doesn't come from the one who called you.
That's right.
And so, Will, I just, in our everyday life and what we do, and just, you know, not just with the strength team, but mm-hmm. people, we try to encourage people to follow Jesus.
Follow Jesus. And one of my favorite psalms is Psalm 91, you know. Those who dwell in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. And that's what you got to keep in mind. Like Mike said, there's a lot of crazy things going on in our world. The economy, all sorts of things are going on. But you got to understand, when you're a child of God and you're dwelling in that secret place, there's protection and there's covering. So you got to always keep that in mind and just know the Lord's looking out for you. But you got to be in that secret place, like the Lord says, in prayer. You know, stand in your word, stand in your Bible. So no matter what's going on in the world, stay encouraged and stay with the Lord. He will protect and cover you. He
Amen.
Promises to do so.
Good word. And so anyway, I just want to encourage you. Lots of good things coming up. The holidays are getting ready to be here.
Yes.
And man, it's just been a great year. We've seen a lot of
seven
people
kids
get
at home. They all want big gifts. I got to tell the kids, you know, Santa Claus makes toys. He doesn't make electronics. The elves don't know
exactly.
how to make
exactly. The elves don't know how to do that.
They don't make the iPods.
But anyway, I want to thank you guys. Thank you for watching the Strength Team. Thank you for following us. Nice. Thank you for all of our partners and our friends who stand with us monthly. Just got that. Check that Haiti mailer that we got out. We're going to have another one that's going to
yes.
come out next month.
Please do.
And we're believing God for big things.
Yes.
Pray for us February 12th through the 15th, Strength Team Haiti 5-Night Crusade.
Yes.
God bless you, and we'll see you in another edition
God bless you.
Of Mike Hagan at the Strength Team Podcast.